Good morning, friends. Hope you are all fine. Friends, you know that we have started with the second chapter, Business Service Part 1. And lot of things we have learned in this. You remember that we have learned a lot of things in that. Hope you remember. The last topic that we have learned is the postal services. I already said to you the postal service is very, very vital services in India. So how many post offices are there in India? I said more than 2 lakhs. And how many years it has been passed? That is 150 years is also been passed. Then I said to you, the first information is the general post and letter. That is a normal thing. Registered post, I explained to you, that is registered acknowledgement. Hope you are remembering. Postal services, in that I have said to you, VPP, value payable at post. Parcel services, and after that I teach to you the express parcel. Yes, and then the saving services. Friends, now today we are going to discuss this saving service in a little bit in an elaborated way. So friend, let's see the topic. Hope you are all fine. Postal department, just like bank, provide various types of saving schemes like saving account, 5-year recurring deposit account, term deposit account, monthly income plan, senior citizen savings certificate, 15-year public provident fund, 5 or 10-year Kisan Vikas Patra, Sukanya Samruddhi account. Now what they want to say, just like bank account, post office saving account can also be opened for which checkbook is given, and now there is a facility of ATM card too. Let's see the coming topic, recurring deposit. Now, what is that, friend? Recurring. According to this scheme, what they want to say, according to this scheme, the account holder has to pay the amount as decided on or before the pre-decided date to the post office. Now, what is recurring? First of all, we should know recurring. Recurring means it's like our hunger. In morning, you feel hungry. For the breakfast is given. In afternoon, we feel hunger. At that time, we'll take a lunch. While in evening time or at the night time, again, we feel hungry. We take the dinner. The same way recurring deposit. The concept is same. So what happens in recurring? A account holder has to deposit a assured sum to the post office at a pre-decided time for 5 years. That is known as recurring deposit. That means if you want to invest in recurring deposit, you have to pay monthly the same amount up to the year of 5 years. So let's see. I think it's clear now what is recurring deposit. Recurring means which is repeated. According to this scheme, the account holder in this scheme, there is not necessary that according in this scheme, the account holder pay the amount, what they want to say? In this scheme, the account holder pay the amount which is decided on or before. The word comes on or before, not after. On or before the pre-decided date to the post office. It's very clear they want to say. What is recurring deposit? Recurring deposit is a scheme in which account holder has to pay the amount to the post office on or before the pre-decided date, right? Now they want to say that at the end of the 5 years, what happens when the account matures? When the account matures, the entire principal, principal means the amount which is deposited by the deposit holder. This is known as principal. Principal means the amount which is deposited by the account holder, along with the interest, because the interest for that only the account holder invests the money in post office, along with the interest, will be received by the account holder. So what they want to say, friend, recurring deposits, it's a very important scheme by the post office. Most of the people are using this recurring deposit for the small saving purpose. What they want to say, according to this scheme, the account holder has to pay a pre-decided amount on or before the date to the post office. At the end of 5 years, when the account matures, the entire principal amount along with the interest will be received by the account holder. After 5 years, now it's clearly say after 5 years period, if required, the duration of the recurring deposit can be extended. It can be again extended. It can be extended for another 5 years. So the account holder will get more interest now. So what they want to say, friend, recurring deposit. According to this scheme, the account holder has to pay a certain sum of money to the post office on or before it. And at the end of the 5 years, the account holder will get the entire principal amount along with the interest will be received by the account holder. After five years, if required, the duration of the recurring deposit can be extended for another 5 years. So I think that is very much clear what is recurring deposit. So one more time, what is recurring deposit? According to this scheme, the account holder has to pay a pre-decided sum to the post office on or before the due date. At the end of the 5 years, the account holder gets the reward in the form of principal as well as the interest received by the account holder. After 5 years, now if the account holder wish that he want to extend more, he can extend the time period for another 5 more years. So I think that is clear. Now, friends, the topic is term deposit. Now, what is that term deposit? The word itself says term. Term means what? It's for a particular time period. That is known as term deposit. So let's see. So we have learned, friend, the first one, recurring deposit. Now we are going to learn term deposit. Ready? Term deposit is like fixed deposit scheme available in the post office. Now, you know that fixed deposit scheme is in the banks. Now, already what I want to say is that the same scheme is there in the post office also. Because we have seen that in urban areas, what happened? In urban areas, the banks are there. While in rural areas, the post offices are there. So the village people also would get all the facilities. So term deposit is like a fixed deposit scheme available in the post office, right? So now what they want to say? As per scheme, accounts can be opened for the duration of 1 year. If account holder can keep for 1 year, he can keep for 1 year, right? For 1 year, 2 year, 3 year or 5 years. It's not for 4 years. 1, 2, 3 or 5 years or ₹200 in its multiple. That means 100 and all. That is not, it's okay. So what we can say, term deposit is like fixed deposit scheme. What we can say, the first line. Term deposit is like fixed deposit scheme available in the post office. Right? Term deposit is like fixed deposit scheme available in the post office. Term deposit is like fixed deposit available in the post office. As per scheme, it can be opened for the duration of 1, 2, 3 or 5 years. Interest calculation is done in every 3 months. interest calculation is done in every 3 months, but the amount of interest is paid on the yearly basis. This account can be transferred from one post office to another. Such an account can be closed any time before the maturity period. So every advantage is given to the account holder. So what they want to say, term deposit is like fixed deposit, but we can say term deposit is like fixed deposit scheme which is available in the post office. As per the scheme, the account can be opened for the duration of 1, 2, 3, or 4, 5 years. Interest calculation is done in every 3 months, but the amount of interest is paid on yearly basis. This account can be transferred from one account, one post office to another. Such account can be closed anytime before the maturity period. So what they want to say in term deposit? Term deposit is like fixed deposit scheme, like the bank, which can be opened in the post office. As per the scheme, it can be opened by the account holder for 1 year, for the 2 year, 3 year, or 5 years. Interest calculation can be done for the 3 months. The amount of interest is paid on yearly basis. This account can be transferred from one post office to the another, and such an account can be closed any time before the maturity period. Clear? Now come friends, national saving certificate. Now what is that? It's an interesting word, national saving certificate. The word itself says national, so it's obviously it's of a government. Term deposit also. Those who want, you just see the difference between the recurring deposit. Recurring deposit means what? If an account holder does not have a money at a lump sum, if he has 500 rupees, 1000 rupees month per month also, he can do his saving. While term deposit means those who have a lump sum amount like 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh, but for the next year, he required that money for any purpose. He has the money for only 1 year. So let for 1 year, he will deposit. For example, he can block the money for 2 years. He will invest for 2 years. If he can invest for 5, then 5 years. So now see the national saving certificate. Those who want to invest in NSC will have to purchase it from the post office. It's why they want very clear that NSC is not available anywhere outside the post office. So they want to become very clear. Those who want to invest in NSC will have to purchase it from the post office. There is no other way out. Those who want to invest in NSC will have to purchase it from the post office. There is no other way out. The duration of this saving certificate is, 5 or 10 years. What they want to say, the duration of this certificate is for 5 or 10 years. The information of interest rate is given in advance. They give around 9%, 10% earlier times. This information of interest rate is given in advance. At the end of the maturity period of 5 or 10 years, the amount can be claimed by fulfilling the required formalities from the... Claimed by fulfilling the required formalities from any post office. So now, friends, we are going to learn National Savings Certificate. What they want to say? Those who want to invest in National Savings Certificate, they have to purchase from the post office. The duration of the saving certificate is 5 or 10 years. The interest rate is given in advance. At the end of the maturity period, 5 or 10 years, the amount can be claimed by fulfilling the required formalities from any post office. So friend, kya kya dekha humne? The first thing we have learned, the recurring deposit. monthly basis the account holder pays the money. Second friend, we have learned the term deposit. The deposit which is done for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year or 5 years. Interest is calculated on 3 month basis, but the amount of interest is paid on the yearly basis. And it can be transferred from one post office to another post office. National Saving Certificate. Now what is that? Those who want to invest in National Saving Certificate will have to purchase it from the post office only. And the duration of this saving certificate is 5 or 10 years. Okay. This clear that. Now comes the topic Kisan Vikas Patra. Now what is that? That it's again another form of investment. Now the word itself says Kisan Vikas Patra. This has been introduced by the government of India in order to make farmers economically more stable. If a farmer has some particular income, he can put that amount in lump sum. And he can demand after 8 years and 4 months. It's now it becomes 124 months, right? So it becomes more than 10 years now. So what they want to say? The depositor in Kisan Vikas Patra gets double the investment. The main feature of this is what? To make the investment double. Yes, the main point of the Kisan Vikas Patra is that it makes the investment double. For after how many months? After 100 months. After 100 months means after 8 years and 4 months. This certificate is available only for prescribed amount. And after the maturity date, the amount can be claimed by fulfilling the required formalities from any post office. The same thing, the same concept, what we can say. The depositor in Kisan Vikas Patra, very simple. The depositor in Kisan Vikas Patra gets double the amount after a period of 100 years. That is 8 years and 4 months. You have to write this one, but actually the number of months and number of years has been checked. This certificate is available for a prescribed amount. And after the maturity date, the amount can be claimed by fulfilling the required formalities from any post office. So friends, we have learned recurring deposit, term deposit, National Saving Certificate, and Kisan Vikas Patra. Patra means certificate. Now comes, friends, the topic is PPF. It is also one type of financial instrument. Let's see. Public Provident Fund. Any individual can open an account in Public Provident Fund scheme. Now, it is not said it is only available in post office. Public Provident Fund, we can open in any bank also. So that's very clear. Any individual can open an account in Public Provident Fund scheme. This period of duration is 15 years. Just see, it's a very, very long duration. No one can stop this. If it stops, the amount will be less, but you cannot withdraw it. The period of duration is 15 years. The minimum amount to be paid, in this account is 500 per annum. It's 500 per annum. And after 15 years, under the prevailing rules, what happened? The duration of this account can be extended by 5 years every time. We can extend also. And it gives more and more interest. This account cannot be closed before 15 years. The money deposited in the account exempted from income tax. The government is promoting this one. You can deposit the money in Public Provident Fund because the government gets the money from you and government can invest in other activities for our country, for anything. In event of death of an account holder, it will be given to the nominee. It will be, just 1 minute. It will be given to the nominated heir, right? So friends, let's see Public Provident Fund. Any individual can open an account in Public Provident Fund scheme. The period of the duration of public provident fund is 15 years. The minimum amount to be paid is 500. And after 15 years, under the prevailing rule, the duration of this account can be extended by 5 years every time. This account cannot be closed. Yes, this account cannot be closed before 15 years. The money deposited in this account is exempted from income tax calculation. In the event of death of an account holder, the amount will be given to the nominated heir. So what they want to say? Any individual can open an account in public provident fund scheme. The duration of this amount is 15 years. The minimum amount to be paid in this amount is 500 rupees per annum. After 15 years, under the prevailing rule, the duration of this account can be extended by 5 years every time. This account cannot be closed before 15 years. The money deposited in account is exempted from income tax calculation. In the event of death of account holder, the amount will be given to the nominated heir. So clear, friends, what are the things we have learned? The first we have learned recurring deposit. Second, we have learned term deposit. Then we have learned National Savings Certificate, Kisan Vikas Patra, and Public Provident Fund. So lot of scheme is given by the Postal Department. Now comes Postal Insurance. Now what is that? Prior to independence of India, as part of a welfare scheme, Postal Insurance was started, like LIC. All employees of central government, state government, other central are eligible for this insurance. There are different types of policies under the postal insurance scheme. The salient features of this postal insurance are the lowest premium and the maximum bonus. So that is okay. Now it's not what we say that more prevalent. It is not prevalent now. So let's see now monthly income scheme. Now for whom it is more valuable? You know that a person works for a particular period of time and after that he requires some monthly amount. He requires some monthly amount to maintain his standard of living. Right? For example, a person works for hardly age of 55 and after that he wants the money to sustain itself, sustain his family and all. So what the government has introduced, a monthly income scheme. Now, what is that? This scheme is useful for those investors who require interest income on a monthly basis. So clearly they say, this scheme is useful for those investors who require interest income on a monthly basis. Monthly basis, if I want. Under this scheme, individual or joint account can be open. Individual or joint account can be open. Individual or joint account can be open. This account can be opened for a period of 5 years. For 5 years, then we can renew it. As per the requirement, this account can be transferred from one post office to the another. If needed, the depositor can withdraw the money on certain terms and conditions after 1 year also. So some of the basic things are there in MIS, monthly income scheme, what they want to say. The scheme is useful for those investors who want the interest on a monthly basis. Under this scheme, individual or joint account can open the account and the period is for 5 years. As per the requirement, this account can be transferred from one post office to the other post office. If needed, the depositor can withdraw the money. The depositor can withdraw the money based on certain terms and conditions after 1 year. Clear? Now comes the money order. Now it's a very simple one, money order. In earlier times it was used. Money order is an arrangement to send the money from one place to the other post office. For this service, post office charges commission. The receiver of the money will have to sign receipt, which will be sent to the sender. Right, it's a normal thing. If you want to just skip, you can skip this. Yes, so we have completed, friends, the postal service. So have a quick revision of that, what we want, what we have learned up to here. So postal service, friends, it's a very, very big topic and very important and very informative topic was that. Right, so we have started with this postal service. The introduction was there. It has more than 150 years has been completed. Jenny, more than 2 lakhs post office in India. Then we have learned the general post office, registered general post, registered post, postal services, value payable at post, speed post, express parcel. And then saving services. And saving services, in that we have learned recurring deposit. And after recurring, we have learned term deposit. Yes, recurring deposit, term deposit, national saving certificate, Kisan Vikas Patra, public provident fund. And then we have learned postal services, postal insurance. In that, we have learned the concept of monthly income scheme. Right. So, friends, we have learned a lot of things. Now, in the coming topic, we are going to learn from godowns. Godowns are there. How many types of godowns are there? What are the requirements of godown? Then we learn transportation. It's a big, big chapter. It's a very important chapter. And after that transportation, we complete this particular topic. So let's see some MCQ, whether we have ready for it or not. Yes. What is the principle? Which of the following principle is not an insurance principle? At most, good faith is there. Principle of indemnity is there. Principle of interest is there. Not a principle. Principle of profit. It is not applicable. Which type of insurance is ancient and widely prevalent? Bahut purana. You know, Lloyd's of London has started marine insurance. How much the foreign insurance company can invest in Indian insurance? Kitna invest kar sakti hai? As per the rule now, 49. How much amount is paid for Kisan Vikas Patra on maturity? Ubi humne padha tha, double. Which type of insurance involves highest risk? Kaun se insurance mein sabse zyada risk hota hai? Obviously we know air insurance sabse zyada. Barabar. In which type of money order service money does not reach to the doorstep of the receiver? Ye maine aapko padhaya nahi hai, it's okay, no problem. Instant doorstep does not reach, instant money order ye nahi pahunchta. What is insurance? Right. Ek bar read karo to aapko pata chalega. Insurance is a contract in which the insurer pays the premium to the insurer and insurance gives an undertaking for which a particular loss. Sab humne padha tha. Theek hai. To bahut bada topic hai aur bahut hi important chapter hai. Isme bahut sari cheeze hai. Answer in brief and all. सो फ्रेंड्स, पोस्टल सर्विस अपना कंप्लीट हुआ है. तो होप आप अच्छे तरीके से इसको पढ़ोगे, रिविजन करोगे और आप जानते हो कि टेस्ट बहुत नज़दीक आ चुका है. तो ठीक है, तो अच्छी तरीके से आप पढ़ाई करो. ठीक है, अभी क्या पढ़ना है? गोडाउन पढ़ना है, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. ओके देन, थैंक यू टू यू ऑल ऑफ यू.